Alrighty, so, just for me, for you, for the record, can you say and spell your first and last name?
Colonel Shavaz, K-H-A-L-L-I-D, S-H-A-V-A-D.
And your correct title is Colonel, correct?
Colonel Shavaz.
All of those, right?
A lot of titles.
But the young gentleman said, you've done a lot.
That's right.
So go ahead and tell me what it meant for you to be back here today at your, was this your original very first alma mater?
It's my first, yeah, it's my first one. I left here 30 years ago, and as I said in the speech, I left here in a bit of trouble. I had to go to jail for some fighting. So I've been working for 30 years to make myself accomplished enough to actually get invited back here. And so it meant a lot to me. It's closure for me because I let a lot of people down, my mother, my father, and all those people who wanted me to be the first college graduate in the family.
And so now you have a multitude of college degrees under your belt. How proud are all of those people and those here at the college?
They're very, very proud of me. I don't think the college actually knew that I was as accomplished with the two doctorates and four masters, but I was contacting my classmates and just kind of begging them to give me an opportunity to come back and speak to the students. So I think sometimes students in their current situation don't understand that you can achieve whatever you want to achieve. You just have to stop listening to the false narratives that people tell you.
And that kind of seemed to be the theme of your speech today.
Yes.
You know, you told them, hey, I was back in here half coherent, half asleep.
That's right.
In your shoes.
That's right.
Just like a lot of students, I came with baggage. Why was it so important for you to be able to speak to those students currently?
Well, I speak all over the country in the Army and also in my own time. And I go to colleges and people seem to lack a lot of self-esteem. I also wrote a book on self-esteem. And people like me, when they see me, they just kind of see the bio. They don't see the trials. They don't see the times where I thought about giving up on myself and giving up on my family. So I want to put that in speech form to show them that they can, I'm the realm of possibility. I was as low as anybody could be, but I still achieved a measure of success just through hard work and kind of managing my time.
And, you know, for any of those students who were here today or weren't here today or will hear you speak in the future, what do you hope that they take away from that? What do you hope that you represent for them?
I do hope I represent the realm of possibility for them, just so they can say this is a normal guy who had a lot of trouble in his life, had a lot of disappointment in his life, and almost gave up, but somehow he stuck it out, and he's achieved a lot. I mean, a lot, just by kind of believing in himself and having a good support system. And I got a wife and three kids and four grandkids, and they support me a great deal.
And so that a lot that you've accomplished, just give me a quick little rundown of the ladder of those degrees and then also your ranking in the Army.
Yeah, I have a doctorate in higher education administration. I have a doctorate in divinity. I also have four master's degrees, and they vary from higher education administration to interfaith, to comparative religion, to ethics and philosophy. One of the things I wanted to do was accomplish as much as I could, just so when I go out and talk to students, to let them know that you can do anything that you want. And so for the military, I rose from the rank of private to colonel, which is a significant jump, which most people probably couldn't accomplish in their lifetime, but I dedicated 14, 15 hours a day trying to achieve my education so I'd be qualified to get to this rank.
Well, is there anything else you'd like to add, you know, about being back here today, the importance to you now that you finally accomplished that?
It's closure for me because I let a lot of people down. You know, my parents sent me here. My mother wanted me to be an intelligent person, a dignified person, and I kind of squandered that because I never told her while she was alive that I was molested. I didn't want to hurt her, but I didn't know how to deal with it. I didn't know internally how to deal with that. So I took that out on fighting with people, and it got me in a lot of trouble, not only here, but the military. And so once I resolved those issues, I had a man in my life who talked to me and said, it's okay, you still can achieve, and nobody looks at you less than a man. And like I said in the speech, he told me he believed in me. I think that's important for students. Most people never tell them they believe in them. They kind of just down them or being condescending or pejorative to them. If students know you believe them, you'll have wonder on what they can achieve.
And that gentleman or anyone else, is there anyone in particular from Jarvis that you need to give a shout out to, you need to give a thank you to, a teacher, a reverend, anybody?
Yeah, William Hampton, he's here in the audience. We had a Mr. Dottie. We had a couple of people, Dr. Johnson and Dr. Charles Jackson, who's passed. They used to call me Dr. J. They used to always say, Dr. J, when are you going to turn in your homework, right? So they were constantly prodding me to do better. I just at that time didn't have the wherewithal. I want to really thank them because they pushed me, especially William Hampton. Sometimes I used to just go hang out in the media room and just kind of sulk. And so he allowed me to do that. He didn't know what was going on inside of me. He just allowed me to do that.
And then one last thing, we were told that you, with your rank now of colonel,
yes.
That makes you the highest ranking Muslim chaplain.
Yeah, I'm the highest ranking Muslim chaplain in the history of all military services. I was the first division level Muslim chaplain in the military history as well. So all of those things, I was hoping just one day that they would invite me back because they, you know, that stuff was on the news in the Army Times and all of that stuff, so.
That ranking alone is extremely significant, like
That's
you
correct.
Said, in all of the history. What does that one mean to you?
Well, believe it or not, it didn't mean as much to me as getting a doctorate degree. My mom got to see me get the doctorate degree before she passed. Nobody in my family had gotten a doctorate degree. So being the first Muslim to do something, it was not insignificant, but it wasn't as significant as me getting the education so my mom could be proud of me.
That's great. Was there anything else you want to add?
Woo! That's it.